More bad news stemming from bisphenol A, more commonly known as BPA. The chemical has been linked to multiple health problems, but a new one was recently added to the list, childhood asthma. BPA has also been linked to hormone abnormalities, behavioral problems, obesity, kidney problems, heart problems, and even cancer. And disturbingly, this was a material often used to make baby bottles and sippy cups. But the FDA banned BPA in both of those products last year. So what exactly is this toxic chemical? According to the Mayo Clinic, BPA is found in lightweight plastics, often storage containers and water bottles. It can also be used in toys and to coat the inside of metal products like soup cans. It can also be used in thermal paper commonly used in cash register receipts. Wow, talk about exposure. The potential for childhood asthma was highlighted in the study by Columbia Center for Children's Environmental Health. It shows that while the FDA ban may help reduce the risk of childhood asthma in the long run, children don't necessarily have to have excessive exposure of BPA to increase the risk of asthma, but rather routine low doses of BPA can be enough to cause health problems. Of course, this does not mean that they will all develop asthma. Just as smoking increases the risk of lung cancer, but not everyone who smokes gets lung cancer, not every child exposed to BPA will develop asthma. And more hopeful news, there are a few ways to help reduce the risk caused by BPA, including asthma. CBS This Morning talked to the study's lead researcher who has some tips.
You eat less canned food. To use stainless steel or glass containers for food, particularly for hot foods or liquids, and to avoid plastics numbers 3 and 7.
The researcher also stressed the findings show a correlation and not a direct relationship suggesting that BPA increases asthma. The study did not look at how BPA is related to asthma in adults, but there is a possibility of a correlation there as well. For Newsy, I'm Jasmine Bailey.